Hi, I'm here to talk about our OSCE self-paced study course by Pharmacy Prep. Let's look at some samples.
Before we get into the sample OSCE cases, here I like to start off with some introduction on the Pharmacist OSCE self-study course. So to find the details, please visit at pharmacyprep.com. And once you've been to those website, then you scroll down and you will find the Pharmacist OSCE course. Once you click on those Pharmacist OSCE course, you will find the details on Pharmacist OSCE self-study course. So once you click this program, you will find the details on the OSCE self-study course, which has several sample cases and their role plays. And further details are for these each role play, we provide you online access to our online platform. That online platform that gives you the access to the courses based on those courses, self-study course includes several hundreds of OSCE role plays and their videos of the role plays, followed by communication skills and problem solutions for each case is presented in those videos. And also all those OSCE case videos are arranged here in pharmacotherapy classes wise. For example, there is a videos for cardiovascular diseases, and there are case and then solutions, and then role plays of those videos are presented. So there you have also the other classes such as endocrine, psychiatric, neurologic, and also there are many more, and that each of them include several OSCE role play cases. I'm absolutely confident and thrilled to announce this course. I'm sure that this definitely helps you to prepare and pass your exam. Also, this course include our several pharmacist OSCE instructors. They have prepared on their cases and recorded those cases, and they're presented here in each of those cases. So you also find those detail of those videos, and you will also great opportunity to learn those videos by watching those cases. So therefore, I can surely encourage you and recommend you to join this Pharmacy Prep Pharmacist OSCE self preparation course that helps you to prepare and pass your exams. So now let's start with the cases samples.
Hello, I am the pharmacist on duty. How can I help you?
I'm here to fill a new prescription for isosorb nitrate.
Sure, I can help you with that. First, to pull up your profile, can I get your full name?
Welcome to the deep dive. Today, we are plunging into a really fascinating source. It's a transcription of a dialogue. We're essentially listening in on a pharmacist counseling a patient about a new heart medication.
Yeah, it's like being a fly on the wall.
Exactly. Think of it as getting an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at a really important health conversation. We're going to try and pull out the absolutely essential information here.
That's right. Our mission in this deep dive isn't just about knowing what the new medication is. We really want to unpack the critical details about how it needs to be taken, and maybe even more importantly, the why behind those instructions. And we're seeing all of this through the lens of this specific patient interaction.
Okay, let's get into this source then. It introduces us to the patient, Joshua Hatt. He's a 55-year-old, a male patient at the pharmacy counter with a new prescription.
Right, and before even getting into the new drug, the pharmacist does those crucial checks, confirming identity, his age 55, and his phone number, which the source gives as 416-223-7737.
Standard procedure, but so important for safety.
Absolutely. Making sure they have the right person, the right contact info.
And then confirming his medical background. This gives us the why for the new prescription. He's got existing heart failure and now a new diagnosis of stable angina.
And importantly, he confirms no known allergies. That's always a critical safety check.
So understanding these conditions, the heart failure, the stable angina, which is that chest pain usually brought on by activity, it's all fundamental context.
Definitely. And another vital step the pharmacist takes is reviewing his current medication list. You absolutely have to do this.
Why is that so critical again?
Well, you're looking for potential drug interactions, maybe duplication of therapy, and just getting the full picture of what he's already managing his health with.
Okay, let's list those out from the source. It paints a clearer picture. He's taking hydralazine, 25 milligrams, 3 times a day.
Right. Hydralazine is a vasodilator. It relaxes blood vessels, lowers blood pressure, makes the heart's job easier.
Got it. Then ramipril, 5 milligrams, once a day.
Ramipril, that's an ACE inhibitor. Also helps relax blood vessels, lowers blood pressure, reduces strain on the heart. Very common for heart failure.
Okay. And bisoprolol, 5 milligrams, once daily too.
Bisoprolol, that's a beta blocker. It slows the heart rate, reduces how forcefully the heart pumps. Good for heart failure symptoms and also for angina, that chest pain.
Reduces the heart's workload, basically.
Precisely. And finally, ASA, 352 milligrams, once a day.
ASA, so aspirin.
Yep, acetylsalicylic acid. At that dose, it's working as an antiplatelet. Helps prevent blood clots. Really important for reducing heart attack or stroke risk in patients like him.
Okay, so quite a lineup already. Managing blood pressure, heart rate, preventing clots, easing the heart's work, and he confirms he's taking these regularly.
Right. So that review sets the stage perfectly before introducing the new medication.
Hello, I am the pharmacist on duty. How can I help you?
I have a new prescription I need filled for simvastatin.
Sure, I can certainly help you with that.
Okay, let's dive in. Today we're unpacking something really fundamental, kind of complex too, based on this great source material you sent us.
Yeah, it's a transcript, right? A pharmacist talking to a patient.
Exactly. A patient named Tim, picking up a new prescription. It's for simvastatin.
Right. A common cholesterol medication.
And our mission here is to sort of peel back layers on this. It looks like a routine chat, but what's really going on?
What's the key info being shared? Why those specific questions from the pharmacist?
Yeah. It's not just about simvastatin, is it? It's about the whole process, the safety checks involved when you get any new medication. What are those, like, hidden layers of protection?
Exactly. So the transcript kicks off pretty simply. The pharmacist introduces themselves, says they need to confirm a few things, and go over the new prescription.
And boom, first thing, verification. The pharmacist asks, could you confirm your date of birth and address for me? Seems basic, but why start there? His name's on the prescription already.
It is, yeah. But, you know, this is absolutely critical. Patient ID isn't just ticking a box.
Okay.
It's the first line of defense against, well, potentially huge errors. Getting that DOB and address right means they know they're talking to the right Tim.
Before sharing health details or handing over pills meant for someone else.
Precisely. Layer one. Simple but vital.
Got it. Okay, so after they know who Tim is, they shift to his health background. Pharmacist says something like, okay, I see here high cholesterol, pre-hypertension, no known allergies. Is that still correct? Checking the file.
And again, it's more than just checking. It's validating that information. Things like pre-hypertension, you know, where the blood pressure's up but not quite officially high.
Right.
That matters. It can affect drug choices. So confirming conditions, confirming allergies, it gives the pharmacist the accurate picture they need to spot any risks with this new simvastatin.
Okay, spotting risks. That leads to the next bit. His current meds. They mentioned ramipril specifically, which Tim started a year ago. Pharmacist asks if he's still taking it as prescribed. But hold on, didn't the doctor already know about the ramipril when they prescribed the simvastatin? Why double check?
That is a really good question. And it really highlights the pharmacist's role here. The doctor prescribes, yes, but the pharmacist is often that final safety checkpoint.
Okay.
The key thing is checking everything Tim takes prescription, over-the-counter, vitamins, you name it, even if it's not in this particular transcript snippet. Because drug interactions, they can be serious.
So they need to be sure simvastatin won't clash with anything else.
Exactly.
Hello, I am the pharmacist on duty, and I see you seem a bit distressed. How can I help you today?
Oh, thank goodness. It's all just so much, these pills. I can't keep them straight.
Okay, imagine this for a second. That daily routine, you know. You're there, medicine cabinet open, maybe bottles all over the counter, different shapes, colors, tiny print, take with food, empty stomach.
Right.
Morning, night. Ugh. Was that pill supposed to be before breakfast or after? It's this mental juggling act, right?
Yeah.
It may be a little bit of anxiety, like, am I getting this right? It sounds small, but for a lot of people, it's a huge source of stress, a real quiet struggle happening every single day.
It absolutely is. And You know, when someone's managing chronic conditions, maybe more than one, it's not just memory. It's a heavy burden. Feels overwhelming. We often don't really think about the cognitive load, the mental effort involved in these complex medication plans.
Exactly. And that's why today we're doing a deep dive into this really insightful source we found. It's an actual dialogue script between a pharmacist and a patient, Jewel Harry. And our mission here really is to unpack this conversation, to see how healthcare folks, pharmacists especially, do more than just hand out pills, how they actually partner up with patients for their well-being, for medication compliance. And we'll see how a solution that sounds kind of simple can just dramatically cut stress and actually improve health.
Yeah, we really will. We'll see the layers, you know, the support, the empathy, how it can totally change a patient's experience, turn that confusion into clarity, anxiety into, well, feeling more in control.
Okay, so let's set the scene. We meet Jill Harry. She's 75 years old, walking into the pharmacy, and you can kind of tell right away she's stressed. Maybe her shoulders are a bit slumped, hands clasped, just looks distressed, overwhelmed by her meds. It's a snapshot, really, that a lot of us can probably relate to, feeling buried under too much information. And when Jill first speaks, her words just perfectly capture that feeling of being completely swamped. She looks at the pharmacist, voice a little tight maybe, and says, "Oh, thank goodness, it's all just so much these pills, I can't keep them straight." You know that feeling, drowning in tasks and information, just needing someone to like throw you a rope. You can feel her exhaustion.
Definitely. And right there, the pharmacist's response, that's key. It sets the tone for real patient care. Instead of jumping to solutions, they first just acknowledge how Jill's feeling. "I understand, Mrs. Harry," they say. "It sounds like you're feeling overwhelmed. And that's perfectly normal sometimes."
Okay. Validation first.
Yeah, exactly. Validation. And they quickly confirm who she is. Jill Harry, 75, doctor is Dr. Oz. That builds rapport, builds trust right off the bat. Just recognizing her distress, that human connection, sometimes that's more important initially than any medical advice.
That makes sense. That empathy probably helps lower the anxiety quite a bit. So rapport established. Where does the pharmacist go from there to understand, you know, the details?
Well, from that point, they skillfully shift gears. They start gathering the crucial clinical stuff, piecing together her health picture with focused questions. They confirm her main conditions: hypertension, that's high blood pressure, and hyperthyroidism, an overactive thyroid.
Right. Not minor things.
Not at all. Both need really careful medication adherence. If they're uncontrolled, you're looking at serious risks, especially cardiovascular stuff like heart attack or stroke. So knowing these conditions right away tells the pharmacist the stakes are pretty high with her medication management.
And that leads right to the heart of Jill's problem, the actual list of medications.
Yeah.
Let's walk through it. It really shows the daily puzzle she's facing.
Mm.
Okay, so she has captopril, 25 milligrams, and that's 3 times a day.
3 times, okay.
Then aspirin, 81 milligrams, just once a day. Propylthiouracil, 50 milligrams twice a day. Right. HCTZ, 12.5 milligrams once a day. And KDUR, also once a day. I mean, just hearing that list, you get why she's feeling overwhelmed.
It's definitely a significant list. And the tricky part, like you pointed out, isn't just how many different meds there are. It's the different frequencies, the timings. Captopril, 3 times a day. That usually means breakfast, lunch, dinner times. It's a pretty strict schedule all day long.
Yeah, that's tough.
Right. Compare that to a once-a-day pill, which is already hard for some people to remember consistently. Now add a twice daily plus 2 other once dailies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a recipe for confusion, even if you're super organized.
And Jill confirms, yes, that's the list. And crucially, she also says she's not taking anything else. No over-the-counter stuff, no herbal supplements. Why is getting that specific confirmation so important for the pharmacist?
Oh, that's absolutely vital for safety, for making sure the meds work right. You know, over-the-counter drugs, even herbals, they seem harmless sometimes, but they can seriously interact with prescription medications. They can change how effective a drug is, or worse, cause bad side effects. So getting that full, accurate picture lets the pharmacist check for any hidden interactions that could mess things up for Jill. It shows how thorough they need to be.
Right, looking at the whole picture before suggesting anything.
Precisely.
So after confirming all that, Jill circles back to her main struggle. She says it again, basically. Yes, that's all of them, and no, nothing else. It's just so many pills to remember at different times.
Mm. Thanks for watching and for showing interest in our OSCE self-paced study course offered by Pharmacy Prep. To join today, visit pharmacyprep.com.